Hi guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about Tailornova. Now, this is a continuation video. Tailornova is an online pattern making software. In fact, I heard so much about it, I decided to try it out. In my first video about the Tailornova, I was able to register, I was able to log in, I was able to put in all my measurements. I was able to do a design. I was able to draft a pattern to fit my measurements, and I was able to download it. So if you want to know how to register and how to use this particular online pattern making software, I have a link directly below this video. So it's better you go watch that video and then come watch this one, because in this video, I'm going to start by printing out my PDF download patterns, and I'm also going to show you how to put them together in this video. So let's go to my computer and let me do the printing, and then let's put the patterns together and see what we can get out of it. So this is my Tailornova account. I've already created two patterns. Unfortunately, I can't create another one, but what we are going to do in this section is to actually print out this pattern. So that's how the PDF printout looks like. As you can see, they tell you exactly how to print. So first you need to print what they call a calibration test page, like so. And then measure 4x4 scale box with a ruler. If the lengths match, you can confidently print your pattern. So you don't just go out and print it. First print it out, measure 4x4 to ensure that the lengths match, as it is shown here, 4 inches, 10 centimeters. So whatever you're using, if you're using inches, if you're using centimeters, just ensure that the whole thing is okay as it is. And then they tell you how to tape it together. They actually tell you that it is grouped, each sheet is grouped by a second number marked on each plate in a group. So you have something like 1-1, 2-1, 3-1, 4-1. Don't worry, it sounds confusing now, but I'm going to show you what they mean by that. For instance, before I come back here, let's go here. Let me show you here. So this is what they mean. The first, my first A4 paper here is 1-1. So if I go to the next one, 1-2. And you find out that they actually tell you what this particular pattern is. It tells you that it's sleeves. It tells you sleeves, and it tells you that it's 4 sheets of paper. So this is what all this means. Then you go again. 1-3, that's still the sleeve. 1-4. 1-5. So that's it. So that's it for the sleeves. So all this one is for sleeves. So you're going to know how you're going to add it together. Now they also tell you how to add those papers one by one. Now they tell you to place page 1 on top of page 2-1, overlapping on the right side edge. Now I'm going to demonstrate this when I finish printing out this my PDF pattern. I'm going to show you exactly what they mean by this. So you see how to, you know, paste it together. At least I will just show you maybe with the arm, so that the video will not be too long. I will show you with the first 5 papers I'm going to print out. So this here now is 2-1. 2-2, 2-3,
to 4 to 5, then 3, 1. So it's just on and on. As long as you follow it the way they just wrote it down. So I looked at it, I counted it, I'm going to print out, I think, 39 sheets of paper. And that is the area I do not like about PDF patterns. You really need to use a lot of printer to do this. Printing. So what I'm going to do now, I have to print this out first and then measure it according to what they said. Print out that page first and measure it so that I can be sure that everything will work out fine. So let me go ahead and print. Before I go ahead and print, I need to show you this. As you can see here, they actually tell you, you know, how many, how you're going to be cutting your fabric. Your center front, your main fabric and all that. They tell you how many pieces you're going to cut. This, of course, I don't need it, but for somebody that is just doing it, starting, you know, it's good to know. I've been sewing, so I really don't need it, but it's good to know. And this is your final measurements, you know. Once you finish joining together the patterns, these are the final measurements you're going to be working with. So it's good once you finish the patterns, you look at it, are the measurements okay before you now place it on your material to cut.
So I've printed out all my papers. This is my pattern. Almost 40 pages of print. You need to have a good printer, of course, and a lot of ink to be able to do this. So I've printed it out, and now this is what I need to show you that they said we should do. Remember that page we read on the computer, that we need to control this before we even start attaching it together. So the only way to do that, get your tape. If it is in centimeters, just measure it from here to here. If it gives you 10, then you know that everything is going to match up and everything is okay. If you have inches, you measure from here to here. If it gives you 4 inches, then everything is perfectly okay. I measure from here to here is 10. So I'm good to go. Now let's start putting this together. So this is the first one. Yeah. This is number 2. I discovered that they said you should cut. You cut it off here and then place it here, but it doesn't work so well for me. So what I noticed is that I would rather fold it, fold that place along the line, like so, and then place it like so. It works better. And then I have, of course, all my transparent transparent sellotape that I've cut into small pieces on my table. No, that makes life easy and fast for me. I will just place it together like that. And do the same thing the other way. So just ensure that everything is in place. So that's it. Look for number 3 and do the same thing. So I'll just fold it again right here. I think this is where the real work is. This joining all these pieces together. This is where the real work is. I'm going to see how long it's going to take me to do this. So, next one, just put it there. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to join everything together. And then when I'm done, I will now cut the pieces separately to be able to place it on my material to cut. So this is what the pattern looks like. It's quite long. I had to do it on the floor because my table is not long enough. So once you put all your patterns together, this is what it looks like. As you can see here, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, everything. See here, this is the hand. This here is the center front. Everything is written down. Like if you look at it there, you see center front. So everything is labeled so that when you're cutting, you will not make any kind of mistake. So that is what it looks like. So that is my side front. And this is the side back. And this here is the center back. And you actually told how many pieces to cut. So it's quite interesting. It looks nice. It took me close to 45 minutes to put this together. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to cut out all the pieces, place it on my material, and then I'll do the sewing. And then let's see how fitting this will be. So I finished putting together all the pieces of my patterns, and it's quite long. So the next thing is I'm going to cut out the pieces, the front, the back pieces, the sleeves and everything, and then I'm going to put my material on it and then cut it out. I'm not going to show you how to sew it. I'll do the sewing and then I'll complete this video by actually showing you the fitting. And then I'll talk about where and where you may need, you may have challenges, or where and where I have challenges when I am sewing or using this Tailornova to sew. Now, before I forget, Tailornova is not free. It has a subscription of $29 a month. But I use the free version. In the free version, you're entitled to download 2 patterns. So you can download 2 patterns, any kind of patterns you want to make, a blouse, a top, a dress, as long as it's just two different styles. After that, you cannot download anymore. So if you want to subscribe to it, it's $29. For me, it's quite cheap for what it has to offer, really. But if you're not really into business, pattern, you know, drafting business or anything, if you're not into sewing business or you're not into fashion business, there's no need to go and subscribe for it. For me, it's a waste of money. So if you're into real pattern drafting and you want to do it as a business, I think you should go for it because it's quite easy. It doesn't take time for you to, you know, come up with your styles and then just print it out, put it together, and then sew or even sell it. Because once you subscribe, you can sell. You can sell your patterns, whatever patterns you create with Tailornova, you know. So it's a good pattern making software for somebody that is just starting. So see you on the other side after I've finished making my clothes, and then we'll see how it looks on me. So this is what the finished product looks like. That is the bell bottom hand. This is it. This is what it looks like. And I do not think the fitting is bad. The only challenge I had really was that it was a little bit too big, despite the fact that I put in my normal measurements. Apart from that, it's easy to use for the beginner. You don't have to go through all the long learning curve of a CAD, computer-aided design program. So I would say that this is a good online pattern making software. If you're a beginner, I don't want all the stress of learning CAD. So with this, I've come to the end of this video. I hope you'll try your hands on Tailornova, the online pattern making system that I use to make this pattern to sew. Try your hands on it and let me know your experience with your comments below. Thank you for watching till next time in my next video.